Hello everybody, AOG Gaming here, back with another video on the finals. This game is going to shit. I don't know what the fuck the developers are doing, but they are doing the wrong things over and over again. It's really sad, right? They have obviously fixed some broken stuff, which is good, like the LH1. I don't know why they ever needed to buff it, but it just goes to show that they literally don't know what the fuck they're doing to this game. They have no idea what to balance, which everything that they're doing now should have already been done before the game released. Like, you should already have done the balancing before the game released. It feels like ever since the game released, they pretty much have created the weapon. They like tested it once or twice and they didn't really balance anything. They didn't play the game. They literally just created the game and then they released it. And that's fine for some people, but really what it does is it makes the game take way too long to fix. Like, it's almost going to be a year, or almost three quarters of a year at this point. And we haven't fucking done anything in this game, other than gotten skins and one more game mode. Like, the balancing is still all over the fucking place. Sometimes it's one class that's stronger than the others. Like, I just don't understand. And heavy is technically the meta, they say. They kind of nerfed it a little bit again. But now they made medium the class. Because again, they won't fucking nerf the defibs or the heals. And they won't nerf fucking mines or grenades. Which is really what you carry as a medium. It's mines and grenades. Sometimes heavy does. Sometimes light does. But mostly, light is using gas or glitch when it comes to grenades, in my opinion. Those are just the better... I mean, you could use frag as well. But they need to nerf these things because they do way too much fucking damage. I literally get one-tapped as a light with the grenade. That makes no fucking sense. They literally have at their disposal a one-tap combo. Yet, for the heavy, they had the one-tap combo with the winch claw. They had to use two things in order to fight me. Yes, technically you have to use two things, but if I catch fire, if I even have a single fucking point of damage as a light, a mine, a grenade, instant death. It just does not make sense. How are you supposed to feasibly play when people are carrying these things half of the time now, since they pretty much make medium the class the most viable class in the game? Like, this game is so all over the place, I don't fucking understand. People are saying, and the YouTubers, they're all like, oh, it's balanced. People say they're hating on it. Of course we're fucking hating on it. They're not doing anything to fix the fucking game. They're doing the bare minimum. The balancing that they're doing isn't balancing. It's like the smallest fixes that don't actually fix the problem or the root of the problem. Because sometimes it's the class that needs balancing, not the weapon. Because there are certain gadgets with the weapon that make it overpowered. But instead, they decide to nerf a weapon that is part of that class because that's the weapon everyone's using with those gadgets. So in turn, that gun becomes worse. It just blows my fucking mind. The gadgets are also things you need to balance. And they rarely do. I mean, the APS they did. Like, finally. Like, for some gadgets, they rarely fucking touch upon them. And it's like... Well, that makes no sense, because you're doing it to basically everything else in the game, and you're leaving like a select few things untouched, and it makes everything unbalanced, because then that thing is definitely going to be better or worse, depending on how you balance everything, you know, buffing or nerfing the weapons or gadgets that you have. So, it really does suck that they don't know what the fuck they're doing. I'm sorry, Embark, but you don't. You really are balancing the game. It's like back and forth. If you were balancing the game... There would be progress towards, you know, having light, medium, and heavy be balanced and the damage be balanced all around. People are like skill-based matchmaking because it deals more damage based on your health. Like, if you have more health as a heavy, you would deal more damage than if you were a light. But I'm like, that's how balancing works, and that's not skill-based matchmaking. That's just skill-based gameplay because you have to use your gadgets properly. Like, it's based on classes, right? It's not just like, oh yeah, have the light deal so much fucking damage that it's really the only viable option. Yeah, it's just really sad. I don't understand. Like, the XP-54 is still the most solid light gun, I would say, in the entire game. The S19 they finally buffed, so great. They have the throwing knives at a pretty decent place, I would say. I don't think they need to get any more nerfed. I think they are fine where they are, but if they're gonna leave everything else broken, then they definitely still need a buff. Sniper, I think, is fine. Sword, they need to take away the emote canceling stuff, which I'm pretty sure they did, or they changed it, I think. I don't know. But if they haven't taken it away, then they have to. Yeah, and then the LH1 is still kind of broken, but I mean, if you were good at it, it's always been broken. For medium, it's the meta class to go to because you have defibs. They still haven't nerfed defibs to the point where it's not literally the best fucking gadget in the game. It is single-handedly the gadget that can win you or lose you any interaction with any team, any confrontations with multiple teams, or just the game itself, like getting the cash out just at the end. Because you are literally able to bring back a fucking teammate. Now, the problem with that is that they also have the healing beam, and they haven't nerfed this thing at all. The nerfs that they've given it to the nerfs that they've done to this thing are pretty much so minuscule that they've done fucking nothing to actually nerf the healing beam. The healing beam cooldown, or sorry, the healing charge that you get needs to be halved in time, and the cooldown needs to be doubled. Because it is fucking ridiculous that one class can not only bring back a whole ass teammate, but also bring them back to full health. And then also keep any teammate that's in the middle of a confrontation or a dogfight alive pretty much the entire time, no matter how much damage you're taking, unless it's two or more people. Usually that's when the damage starts stacking too much. But if you just have a couple of stray bullets hitting you, you're completely fine. So again, it's just appalling to think that they think they're actually progressing with the balancing, because they're not. I mean, they've done like of two. I would say there's a couple of things that they actually balanced that fix the game. So, most notably the recent one, what's the Winch Claw? I agree. They pretty much made that like a one combo thing. But I think it's dumb that they did that, but not did anything to the medium class. Heal beams, defibs, and grenades. I cannot stress grenades and mines. The amount of fucking damage they do is ridiculous. 150, 149. It's pretty much the whole health of a light. You're not able to survive as a light. And honestly, it's pretty sad, because it's like you're insta-killed as a light. Like, they wonder why people have such bad, like, people lights. There's such controversy over light. It's because you have to be extremely fucking good. I know people say, like, oh, no, you just have to be good at the class. No. You have to know what the fuck you're doing, especially if you are ranked. You have to know when to leave and when to stay alive. Like, I've been on one health so many times because that is usually what you end up as light. That is playing good. You're able to kill a couple teammates from the opposing team and then get out before you're completely killed. And just like run around and double back if you need to help your other teammate, or grab one of your teammates, run out, and then revive them in a corner somewhere. That is how you play fucking light. You're supposed to go in as fast as possible and leave as fast as possible, or run around and do damage. The problem is that there's a million fucking ways to one-shot a light. You literally just have to shoot them once, and then you can RPG them. You can not shoot them once, sorry. Hit him with a bullet. Hit him with fucking anything. A Winch Claw. And they're one-tapped with anything. It does not make sense to me. There's so much that every other class has over light in terms of health that it feels like light is slowly becoming a meme class and less of a competitive class. Because, yeah, it's still fun to play. But why would I play lights when I have healing beam and defibs? Like, I can just keep a whole team alive. Yeah, light is fun because it has the dash, it has the evasion. I could have DMAP with medium. I could have the jump pad. I could have the zip line. So, light is now, like, pretty much worse than a glass cannon. It's a glass cannon without the firepower. It's literally just glass. Yeah, it deals some damage here and there because it's sharp, but it's really easy to shatter and break. And then it's gone. So yeah, I mean, I could speak about how they could balance stuff, but again, I really don't care. Like the amount of feedback that we try to give Embark and the things that they end up bouncing is just funny. Like unless there's an insane amount of pushback, they won't change anything. Hand and point to the Winch Claw. Also the defibs, people were complaining about them a lot. I still think they're broken. Because three defibs on a team means you literally cannot kill that team. You have to sweat so hard, and especially when you're solo queuing, because your other teammates are just fucking morons, I'm sorry. Only like 2% of the time do I get actual teammates that are pretty much at my skill level. The other time I get people who fucking around, they start fighting people, or like I'm like literally facing them opposite, and somebody's shooting at me from like a little bit to their left or right from behind the wall or something that they're standing in front of, and they just stand there. They look left, right, they're like, oh, where the fuck is he? And it just appalls me, like, are you fucking kidding me? I am shooting at him, and I am looking directly at fucking you. So where do you think he is? Right fucking behind you. And he's like, oh, I didn't see him because I was on the. No, you were literally right next to him, and you didn't kill him, and we lost the cash out because of that. It's just pretty sad. I really don't understand. Yeah, so it's like there's a ton of other stuff. Like the matchmaking is still pretty dog water. I don't understand why they think they're making any improvements to it. It's pretty much just absolute trash. It is. I don't understand how people do that. I don't understand how companies do that. Like there are games with good matchmaking. It's not that hard to do. It is really not that hard to do. You just make a ranking system and you stick to it. You don't do all this bullshit where you mix ranks together because you don't have enough players or something. Like, I just don't understand. Yeah, I mean, like, I'm not gonna quit the game because I'm still enjoying it to s more than I am not enjoying it, but it's going to the point where I'm like, yeah, I mean, what did fucking Embark expect? They haven't done anything to fix the game, really. They've only fixed major issues that have arisen. There were like really broken stuff. LH1, Winch Claw, defibs. They nerfed them. That was a long time ago, though. You understand what I mean. They and the APS, like they nerfed things that were obviously insanely broken. But it took them fucking forever to do. And when they did, only some of them actually got nerfed to a decent place. Like the APS, I think it is at a great place. It's still a decent amount of projectiles you have to use. I still think it's a lot. I think two would be better because you can still place them down really fast. But I mean, four projectiles and it's gone, that's fine because there's again grenade launchers and you need a balance because it was a counter to that since that was the only thing that could really counter it. Yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it with the APS. Winch Claw, obviously, the one combos, they had to nerf that. The LH, just three tap on a light, it's just fucking ridiculous. The daggers need a nerf, obviously, because they could. I think they could three tap a light, which is also pretty not like headshots, obviously, but they're pretty easy to land. What else did they nerf? Like they nerfed weapons, but again, when they nerf weapons, they're not actually doing the right type of buffing or nerfing. They're doing it based on how many people are using the weapon, which is not. Like, that doesn't mean the weapon is necessarily broken. That just means more people are using it because it's a. They like the gun better. That could also be the reason. But usually it is that the gun is better and more meta use, especially in the higher arenas. If they should literally just look at the diamond players that are diamond one and above and see what they're running and then understand that these things are broken and everything else is dog water or at least worse than it, because that is literally why people in the higher ranking arenas use what they use, because it's the fucking meta. It's really not that fucking hard. It's that simple, Embark. Top 500 players, you already have a fucking rank for them. I don't know, ask all your diamond players. If you are diamond, please send us your ID and what's like a list or just please send us your ID or and give us consent to. Well, I know that would be looking into your computer and stuff. So I guess you would just send them screenshots or just send them a list of a docs or something. Of the classes and gadgets you're using and weapons. And then they would fucking understand. Medium is literally the only class people should be using right now because It's the only viable fucking class. It's the only one with a broken class. It has the AKM and the FCAR, which are amazing at pretty much any range, and they deal a ridiculous amount of damage for headshots, especially the AKM. I mean, it's decent, right? But it still feels like a lot. They have defibs and heals, so they can keep their entire team alive and keep them like reviving. Like I will tell you how many times my team goes in, kills all of them but one. Two of us are low. We dip out for a second, come back in, and all of them are back within one fucking second. Not even the statues that are still like coming back alive. No. All of them are up with heal beams out, three quarters of their fucking health, except for the one that revived them because he's probably at full health since he got healed by the second guy he defibbed or whatever. And it's just over. It's like, what in the fuck do you mean you're balancing the game? You haven't even fucking touched the healing beam. Compared to everything else in the fucking game, medium class has barely been touched. The only thing you've touched are weapons. Grenades, mines. Like maybe four or five times you've done something to that, and those most of those things were like a damage tick up or a damage tick down. Like they were very minuscule compared to everything else. Mines and grenades need to deal either half or three quarters of the damage they do now, because the fact that they can literally one tap a lot, it's literally a one tap combo. And I know people are like, oh, that doesn't make sense because you can't one tap them. Well, that's what people were calling the Winch Claw and the Hammer. You still had to use your specialization and a melee weapon. Those are two fucking things. What do you have to do for a mine and a grenade? Oh, I don't know. Literally tap them a one time with the bullet, which is arguably a lot more valuable, or sorry, cost efficient, because you can just fucking reload instead of using your Winch Claw. Like they should have left the Winch Claw the way it was. No, actually, they should have nerfed it, yeah. Because the one tap combos were kind of dumb. But if they were gonna nerf the Winch Claw, they should still nerf all this healing stuff. Like, yeah, Light was pretty much getting shit on because of the Winch Claw. They're still getting shit on. They tried to buff a weapon to make it balanced. How is buffing one fucking weapon going to fix an entire class, Embark? Like, I can see what you're doing. You buffed the LH because you had the Winch Claw thing. People were getting macerated, or like they were just dying everywhere, right? Like it was so easy to kill a Light. It was literally one tap. And it just didn't make sense. So you nerfed it. And then you also had the LH thing. And then you waited a little bit. And then you nerfed it. And it's like you're trying all these things that you should have already fucking done before you released the game. And I know these are new things, like the Winch Claw is a new thing, but the LH isn't. The LH has been around for fucking ever. It never needed a buff. Maybe a little bit, like a small damage buff. But other than that, I thought that that gun was pretty decent. And I used it in Power Shift when it came out. I still used it in. Like, I still used that gun a while ago. Because it's still a pretty decent gun. It's how you use it and how skilled you are. I just don't understand why they're doing this. Like, they're not actually balancing the right things. They're over buffing or over nerfing stuff, and then they're just bringing back stuff down to its base or nerfing it again. So, Embark, this is not good for longevity. I'm sorry. But if you think this game is gonna last 96 days by you guys repeating the cycle, I'm sorry, but it's not. It's fun. But revenue-wise, it's just gonna keep shrinking. It's not sustainable. Because the respawns still suck. Did I mention that? You still get third-partied and fourth-partied. Like, if it's possible to do that, you haven't fixed the spawns. I'm sorry. But it's. I'm not sorry. I'm not sorry. Because that's 100% on you, Embark. If you are able to get third-partied in this game, which is every fucking game, literally every game, there is another team trying to take the same point as you. When there's already a team you're fighting, that is what a third party is. Or even a fourth party, which is then another second team coming back behind that. It literally happens every game. The third partying is so bad, and Embark has literally ignored it the entirety of this game. And that is the one thing that will keep this game down no matter what. you're not fixing the third partying. You did not do anything to the spawns. Stop telling me that you fixed the spawns. They're still absolute shit. You should only spawn your cash out when you are starting out, and it should be one other team that is spawning near that cash out. The other two teams should spawn near the other cash out, and the other teams, sorry, so if you're with, like, if you're going to a cash out, and let's say purple's here, you're blue, and let's say orange and red are on the enemy team, right? Orange and red should be twice as far from your objective that you spawned closer to than they are to theirs. That means that you are also twice as far from that other objective that orange and red are closer to. Because otherwise, you can literally just run to it and just wait, and then third-party people, which is literally what people do. It has become not a fun game to play. It has become a toxic game style. And they literally are like, oh, did you have fun? Or was this, what were they, toxic behavior? You literally are pushing for toxic behavior in the game, Embark, by literally still allowing for third-partying to be the fucking meta. Like, it is obscene. It is retarded, I have to say, even. How many times I get third-partied. It is literally every game, if not twice every single game. And I mean every round of, like, knockouts for cash-out mode, or every round of TA. But TA is a little different, so that's a little different. The cash-out mode. So, they say they're fixing it. They have 96 days to do it. But again, this game mode has been out for already, what, 6-7 months now? It's almost been half a year. It's basically been half a year. So, again, like, I don't know what the fuck you're doing, Embark, but you're not doing anything. Like, you're pretty much just pressing buttons. Like, you're flipping switches and flipping them back down. That's literally what you're doing. Weapons can be balanced after you balance the classes. Because if you're balancing weapons first, like, you have to balance the health first of the classes. The light has way too little health, or you just have too much damage when it comes to certain gadgets in the game. If lights are dealing too much damage, then give them a little bit more health and take away a little bit more damage. It's that simple, right? Like, I don't understand. And if heavies are dealing that much damage, like, you can balance them all across, so I guess you would have to tweak the... And the thing is, like, again, you could do it per class. Like, the daggers deal more damage to heavies than they deal to mediums, because heavies have more health. I don't understand what the problem is with that. People are like, that's skill... Like, skill-based matchmaking is... That's when you're... Match is made based on skills, right? Isn't that... Like, it's a ranking system, right? Basically? Because that shows your skills. But it's based on... Like, I... Skill-based matchmaking. SBMM. Right here. SBMM. Yeah, I mean, I don't understand why it's so bad. But I don't understand why people are mad about SBMM. Why, but how is one... Okay, so here's what it says the issue with skill-based matchmaking is. That simply playing with the team can confuse the equation since one player might be much higher skilled than the other teammate. That literally takes the fucking SBMM out of the equation. How is that skill-based matchmaking? Skill-based matchmaking should be equal-based skill. Not somebody has higher skill on one of the teams or something like that. That's not skill-based matchmaking. That literally doesn't fucking make sense. Oh, because I see. So it's harder to play with people who are good because you're gonna be paired up with people, or you're gonna be playing against people who are good as well if you're a noob. Well, why the fuck are you playing with good people then? Like, that makes no sense to me. If they really want to introduce you to the game, just start a fresh account. Like, I don't understand why it needs to be. And of course you're gonna lose all the matches. You're playing with higher. Like, it's the same thing in this game. That's how ranking systems work. I get paired up with bots all the time. That's just how it fucking works. I don't know why people are mad about that. That's just how the game fucking works. Yeah, it's a shitty system, but they don't fix it. Because there are people, when you solo queue, that's gonna be the thing. People are gonna be at different skill levels no matter what. So, even if you weren't basing off of skill like level and you were just doing off of rank, eventually you'll hit the rank where your skills match. Like, it eventually becomes skill-based matchmaking no matter what, because that is just how the games are coded to play. You can't pair up a level 57 with a level 0 account. Like, that just does not make sense to me. Of course, they've done it in this game, which it doesn't make sense to me either how that how people are okay with, like, I don't understand. Like, I don't understand why having the same difficulty experience is a bad thing. I mean, that's not true. Everyone ends up having the exact same difficulty experience. That's not fucking true. Everyone who's diamond players or above are gonna be sweating a lot more than any lower lobby, even if it's skill-based matchmaking. Like, I don't, the argument on that is illogical. Yeah, you end up having the same difficulty experience. Otherwise, it would be fucking unfair. And it's not the same anyway, even though it kind of is. It's the same in terms of, yeah, it's gonna be mostly the same gameplay because the skills are the same, are on the levels that they should be. But in terms of, like, how crazy the moves or plays are gonna be, or how sweaty they are gonna be, the higher, more skilled players are obviously gonna have way better gameplay than the lower skilled players. Like, it's just how the gamers work. Like, people who are higher skill based should be playing with people who have better skills. Otherwise, you're pretty much giving them an advantage just because they're better than people who haven't played the game as much. Like, the argument for SBMM is just retarded. Again, sorry. Like, it just makes no sense. Get good at the fucking game. That's simple. It's not that hard. You just play the game over and over again until you get good at it. Do anything for a certain amount of time and you eventually get good at it. Unless you have no talent for it, which then you'll probably notice pretty fast. Like, that just makes no sense to me. It destroys your progression by forcing your KD and win-loss ratios to 1.0. Well, duh. If you're always have more kills than everybody else, like, it's gonna throw off the balance of the game. Like, you should only have that many kills when you're progressing to your skill level. Once you hit your skill level, you should pretty much be even across the board with everybody else. Like, it's not a wall, it's just where your skill is at because you have been playing with people who aren't pushing you to improve your skill. Okay. Some people are just retarded. I'm sorry. Humanity needs to understand that it is dumb, it is ignorant, and it is spoiled children. Like, that's fucking retarded. It's literally just skill. They're basically saying, oh, skill-based matchmaking is bad because it makes skilled players just better at the game. Like, what the fuck do you mean? They're more skilled? Yes, that's literally what the definition of more skilled is. They're able to get more kills, they're able to outplay, and they're able to play really well. So they therefore in turn they should be playing with each other. They shouldn't be playing with all the noobs and plebs because they are just gonna have a horrible time. Well, like I just don't understand. I don't understand. Yeah. All right, well, that's my note. Thank you all for watching as always. AOG Gaming here. 205 subscribers not checked. Y'all are amazing. Yeah, I mean, this game should be called the Dota Third Party, not the Finals, because that is pretty much what it is. It feels like there's skill-based matchmaking because I'm either placed with really horrible people, and then I'm placed with even worse people, until eventually I'm just shitting on the enemy teams left and right, and then I'm placed with teams that are really like because I'm good, but I'm solo queuing and my team still sucks. Like we still lose. Like it just does not make sense. I could have an immaculate score. Like all my numbers are golden at the end. Like I was the best person on my team. Doesn't matter. Yeah. Now I'm not bragging. I'm not saying I'm a good player. I am by no means a good player. I am a decent player. I'm a high IQ player. Because I try to outplay the enemy with plays rather than just out damaging them because that just. I mean, that's not fun. Every shooter game has that. You can kill somebody by dealing more damage and taking less damage. Woohoo! You discovered something new! Jesus fucking Christ, humanity. We're all doomed because everyone is just dumb. Nobody can think for themselves.